International News Today, July 17, 2019. Welcome to the BitMedia International News Today with the latest world news headlines and stories. To keep updated with the latest news and insights, subscribe and hit the bell notification. Now for the news. Trump tweets declared racist by U.S. Congress. The U.S. House of Representatives has voted to condemn President Donald Trump after a series of attacks aimed at four congresswomen. The symbolic resolution denounced Mr. Trump's racist comments that have legitimized fear and hatred of new Americans and people of color. Mr. Trump had been accused of racism and xenophobia for telling the members of Congress to leave the country. The president has since tweeted, "I don't have a racist bone in my body." The hometown of Donald Trump's grandfather has a message for him. When it became clear that Donald Trump would be the Republican nominee for president in 2016, the small German town of Kallstadt suddenly became a destination for journalists and tourists curious about the unlikely candidate's roots. Trump's grandfather had been born there and migrated to the United States in search of opportunity. Many of the 1,200 residents of the town, uncomfortable with the spotlight and the populist rhetoric Trump espoused, wished the eventual American president would forget about their quiet corner in Germany. Now, in the aftermath of Trump urging four Democratic congresswomen to go back to the crime-infested places from which they came, some in this once economically depressed town are urging the American president to remember where his own family came from. Jeffrey Epstein's treatment is worse because of his wealth. Prosecutors have singled out Jeffrey Epstein for harsher treatment than other defendants because he is rich. Lawyers for the American financier claimed on Tuesday in arguing that Epstein should be freed while awaiting trial on sex trafficking charges. Federal prosecutors say Epstein, who is 66, should be denied bail because there are no conditions under which a man with his money and international connections could be prevented from fleeing the country if he was released. To be sure, wealthy defendants do not deserve preferential treatment. But they certainly shouldn't be singled out for worse treatment, in effect, categorically disqualified from bail on the basis of their net worth. Epstein's attorneys wrote in papers filed in federal court in New York on Tuesday. Both prosecutors and defense lawyers filed additional documents on Tuesday, as U.S. District Judge Richard Berman weighed whether Epstein should be granted bail, and if so, under what conditions. Berman said he would issue his ruling on Thursday. Sudan military and civilian sign deal. Sudan's ruling military council and opposition leaders have signed a power-sharing accord after all-night talks. "It is a historic moment for the country," the deputy head of Sudan's ruling military council, Mohamed Hamdan Hamidi Dagalo, is quoted as saying by AFP news agency. Sudan has been in turmoil since the military ousted President Omar al-Bashir in April. Protesters have been demanding the military hand power to civilians. Those protests turned deadly in a crackdown on June 3, which left dozens of protesters dead. Pentagon grilled on use of weaponized ticks on public. The Pentagon has been ordered to tell U.S. Congress whether it unleashed weaponized ticks on the public that may have caused the spread of Lyme disease. The United States House wants to know if the country's Defense Department experimented with weaponized ticks and other insects, and if they were ever unleashed on the public. The House of Representatives has voted in favor of ordering the Pentagon Inspector General to disclose to Congress whether this happened. An explosive report from Washington newspaper Roll Call states, the bizarre amendment was voted during a House debate on July 11 on the fiscal 2020 Defense Authorization Bill. The U.S. government banned research into biological weapons in 1969. However, the House suspects research into protecting the country's military personnel may have continued. North Korea and China accused the U.S. of using biological warfare during the Korean War in the 50s. However, the U.S. denied it. The new investigation could provide damning information confirming a possible connection between insect experiments and the spread of tick-borne diseases such as Lyme disease. Thank you for listening to the BitMedia International World News Today. To keep updated with the latest world news, subscribe and hit the bell notification. Until next time.